You say you're vegan, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah. Well, omega-3s and stuff, so you should really get on some fish oil supplements for your omega-3s. No, I don't need to do your blood work. Just take them.
Emily from BiteSize Vegan, and welcome to another Vegan Nugget. Today is the second installation of my interview with nutrition powerhouse and the mastermind of nutritionfacts.org, Dr. Michael Greger. This series is about addressing the nutrients of greatest concern for those switching to a vegan diet. Last session, we took on the monolith of protein and found out that it's really not an issue. And today, we're moving on to another common concern, omega-3 fatty acids. Let's hear what Dr. Greger has to say.
So another concern that people have going vegan, and they usually get this concern because, well, we're talking about omega-3 fatty acids. People think, okay, when they hear omega fatty acids, they think fish supplements and fish oil and those kind of things. So there's always this concern of like, where am I going to get my omega-3s? So would you mind telling us a little bit about omega-3 sources on a plant-based diet?
Sure. So omega-3 fats are essential fats, meaning we have to take them into our diet as opposed to other fats that our bodies can make on their own. And essential fats, these essential fats are found in, concentrated in flax seeds and walnuts and chia seeds and hemp seeds, and get some in some dark green leafy vegetables. This is the short chain omega-3 fatty acids called alpha-linolenic acid, and our bodies can actually elongate these short chain omega-3s into the long chain, so called the marine omega-3s, DHA and EPA. These long chain omega-3s aren't found naturally in the kind of terrestrial plant-based diets, but actually are made by little algae out in the ocean. And so that's where the fish get it from. The fish don't make it either. The fish get it from the algae. And so if we wanted to get a long-chain source of omega-3s, DHA, EPA directly in our diet, we could cut out the middle fish and take algae-based supplements. So then you can get the omega-3s without the industrial pollutants that have so contaminated the aquatic food chain, even distilled fish oil capsules. But this would be predominantly for brain health, not heart health, as disappointingly the fish oil supplements and these long-chain omega-3s have not reduced risk for cardiovascular disease, as well as advice to increase your meals of fatty fish, does not seem to be as cardioprotective at all compared to early studies that pointed in that direction. But for brain health, when people call us a fathead, maybe kind of true, about a third of our brain by weight is DHA, this long-chain omega-3. And so the question is, yes, we can make it, but can we make enough for optimum health? That's still a question that's up in the air. Maybe not enough for two brains, so women before conception may want to get a direct source of DHA in their diet, which would be from an algae-based, regardless of what they think about animals, algae-based is the only way you're going to get contaminant-free source of long-chain omega-3s. So start taking a DHA supplement, and then particularly as we get older, it might be a good idea to get a long-chain omega-3 like DHA in our diet. So I recommend 250 milligrams of algae-based DHA every day. But if you do, like if you actually measure these long-chain omega-3 levels in the general U.S. population, vegans have the same level that omnivores, the rest of the population does, but that's because no one really eats fish here in the U.S., and that for optimal levels, we probably need to do better, and so the only contaminant-free source are the algae-based sources.
With omega-3s, I think sometimes people get a little confused with is it the quantity of omega-3 versus omega-6, or is it the ratio that's the most important?
So, well, you need to get enough. But the ratio matters in that conversion process. If you're getting a direct source of DHA, for example, then you don't really have to worry about your ratio. But the ratio does affect, because they compete with each other for the same enzymes. that elongate these omega-3 fatty acids. So if you have a lot of omega-6 in your system, then the little omega-3 you got in flax seeds or walnuts is kind of pushed to the back of the line. You make more of the long-chain omega-6s. And so if you're relying strictly on these terrestrial plant-based sources, then, yeah, it's a good idea to not consume omega-6-rich oils and junk food. This is really where you get the major sources of omega-6. So cottonseed oil, corn oil, safflower oil, sunflower oil. You know, I mean, these aren't healthy foods for anybody, but particularly in people that want to kind of optimize that elongation process, you'd want to stay away from those foods.
I hope you enjoyed hearing from Dr. Greger about omega-3 fatty acids. You certainly don't have to eat fish to get your omega-3s. As Dr. Greger so aptly pointed out, the reason that animal products have the nutrients that we desire is because those animals get them from eating plants. So cut out the middle animal, the middle fish, and go to the source. Then you get all the pure nutrients without all of the extra crap like cholesterol that comes packaged in animal products. The omegas in fish come from their consumption of algae, so why not start there? Otherwise, it's like saying, hey, I really like your hair color, and then scalping you so that I can wear your hair rather than asking you what kind of dye you use. You're welcome for that visual. If you enjoyed this look into the non-fishiness of omega-3s, give the video a big thumbs up and share it around to spread the nutritional truth. If you're new here, be sure to hit that big red subscribe button down there for more awesome vegan content every Monday, Wednesday, and most Fridays, and to not miss out on the rest of the videos with Dr. Greger. If you want to help keep BiteSize Vegan educating, check out either of the support links in the video description below, and for perks and rewards for your support, just click on the Nugget Army icon there or the link down below for more information about joining up. And hey, check out some of the related videos while you're here. And all of the links here and to anything I've mentioned will be in the video description below for those of you who are on your phone or your tablet. Now go live vegan, cut out the middle fish, and I'll see you soon.
You know, vegan and omega-3s with the vegan. I don't know if you're in the screen. You might be in the screen.